Destination Football. The world is shaped like a big football. Now you've got a season ticket, you can see it all. From the Vera Frames to San Siro, from Amsterdam to the Olympico. There's a Mexican wave at Galatasaray, and Stamford Bridge isn't far away. Hear the crowds all roar, feel the tension in the air. Yeah, Destination Football takes you there.
This week, we join the centenary celebrations of glamour club Real Madrid. The Bernabeu comes alive as the reigning World Club champions proudly look back on a record that's second to none. The neutral supporter heads to cosmopolitan North London to find out what it's really like to be a gunner. We join the band of loyal supporters who cycle 30 kilometres from Carlton to Sunshine in Victoria to cheer on the Melbourne Knights. And former Blackburn Rovers and Australian great Robbie Slater relives his greatest playing moment.
They're always celebrating at Real Madrid. Goals, championships, and more championships. This year they had even bigger cause for celebration, the Real Madrid centenary. For 100 years, these Spanish giants have been winning almost everything. 28 Spanish League titles, 17 Spanish Cups, and 9 European Championships for starters. In all, Real Madrid has won 10,000 trophies. Count them. These fans have been spoilt rotten. Formed in 1902, the club's first cup arrived 2 years later. It started raining silverware at Real Madrid in the 50s and 60s when they won 5 consecutive European championships and 8 out of 10 Spanish League titles. Only the most prized possessions are on display in the magnificent Santiago Bernabeu Stadium. Billed as the best trophies in history, the display is open every day except Monday from 10:30 to 7:30. The cost, only €5.
Qantas Airways is offering discount fares to Madrid for the month of May. Economy starts from just $1,950. Or call Gulliver's Travels for a special deal that includes 2 Real Madrid match tickets.
Real Madrid's Bernabeu Stadium, one of football's 7 wonders of the world. And you can be sure the first series of 4 Destination Football will include other magnificent venues such as the San Siro, Old Trafford, Barcelona's new camp, and Feyenoord's De Kuip Stadium. Get on your bike and head west with these Knights supporters who take the environmentally friendly option in getting to the big match.
There's no yellow leader's jersey to be seen in this group of Australian cyclists. That's because it clashes with their club colours. These dedicated Melbourne Knights supporters ride 25 kilometres to Knights Stadium each home game to see the men in red and white go round.
It's a really difficult ground to get to. It's probably the most difficult ground in Melbourne to get to if you don't live out west. So we try to make it a fun day to get there and make it a big day. So we have a beautiful bike ride beforehand. We get to the game, enjoy the game, and it's sort of, you know, it's fun.
Justin Anderson and his band of loyal supporters live in Carlton, Victoria, not too far from Glamour Club South Melbourne. But their decision to follow the Knights, located on the western outskirts of town, was influenced by several factors.
At the time, when I started getting into soccer, there were 3 Melbourne teams. There was Carlton were in there as well. And I'm a Collingwood supporter in the AFL, so there's no way I could support a team called Carlton, no matter what sport they played. And at the time, South were doing really well, so just to support the underdogs, pretty much.
Their dedication has not gone unnoticed. Knights management has been aware of these eco-friendly supporters for quite some time and recently rewarded them with season passes.
When we saw the pushbikes turn up and it looked like the Tour de France had turned up here today, we thought to ourselves, well, these guys really need some recognition, and we decided to hand out season passes to them.
The Knights may be the National Soccer League's underdogs, but with dedicated fans like Justin Anderson and co, it's obvious a repeat of the early 90s glory days when Mark Viduka, Joe Spiteri and Denny Teato wore the red and white may not be too far away.
Justin Anderson and co are a classic example of supporter commitment and passion. Each week on 4 Destination Football, we'll salute the colourful fans that make this game so unique. Celtic's Blantyre boys, Leo De Hoon and Elvis.
Looking very sexy, mate.
Thank you, sir. You too. Thanks.
Well, I quit my job down at the car wash. I left my mama a goodbye note. By sundown, I left Kingston with my guitar under my coat. I hitchhiked all the way down to Memphis. Got a room at the YMCA. For the next 3 weeks, I went a-hunting them nightclubs looking for a place to play. Well, I thought my picking would set them on fire, but nobody wanted to hire a guitar man.
So, this is the highly revered Highbury Football Ground, or the Arsenal, as